also think that the crypto markets have never been this confusing before? Guess what? El Salvador, where the US dollar was once adopted as an official currency, recently became the first country in the world to make Bitcoin legal tender. All this in just 3 days of planning and implementation. But on the other hand, countries like China are cracking down on Bitcoin mining, and poor miners are having to relocate to other countries. So yes, you are right. The world of financial markets can be extremely mysterious. And to help you demystify this world, StockGrow is out with its own podcast, Mind the Markets. It's only fair that we head to Dalal Street first. While the Indian equity markets started the week by opening with a gap down, they were quick to reaffirm that the bulls are very much in control. Fears of Delta, the most transmissible coronavirus variant so far, were just shrugged as both Nifty and Sensex ended just moderately shy of their previous peak, closing at 15,850 and 52,890 respectively. Banking and metal stocks were among the best performers yet again. Not a surprise, given that banking sector recorded its highest ever annual profits and metals are experiencing a super cycle. As more states open up, consumer sentiment certainly seems to be picking up. June's power and fuel demand were up 9 and 15% respectively. And if the record high 78.3 million credit card transactions in June are anything to go by, economic recovery seems to be underway. Global optimism certainly seems to have a role in this week's rally too. US President Joe Biden's talks on the infrastructure plan worth $1.2 trillion have led the S&P to gain 2.7% and end the week on a record high. Capitalizing on this rally was Microsoft, which became the only company after Apple to hit the $2 trillion market cap, making it worth whooping two-thirds of the value of all Indian companies put together. And as we speak of big companies, how can I possibly miss the Reliance annual general meeting that took place on Thursday? A new Jio phone in partnership with Google and 75,000 crore rupees green energy investments, among several other big projects, failed to cheer investors, and the stock finally slipped 2% on Friday. So, are there any burning issues at the back of the Indian investors' mind? Certainly. The Indian government's dependence on debt during the financial year 2021 rose and is now at a whopping 58% of the total GDP. In other disturbing news, RBI's latest data confirmed that the Indian household savings had fallen significantly due to COVID. And to make matters worse, petrol and diesel prices were hiked again on Thursday. Price has now crossed the 100 rupee mark in more state capitals. This led India to flag concerns about oil price-induced inflation with the OPEC. This refers to the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. Mind you, India is the third largest importer of crude oil, which officially touched a high of $76 last week, a price that was last seen only in October 2018. However, OPEC is all set to meet next week to decide on tweaking the supply to control price rise. Whether or not Brent crude touches $100 is to be seen. But it is certain that this price rise has helped ONGC clock record high profits in the fourth quarter of financial year 2021. Speaking of other significant market events up for next week, we have June's preliminary balance of trade and the market manufacturing PMI numbers coming up on Thursday. A good performance in the manufacturing and export-import departments can certainly cheer the markets further. But be warned, my friend, technical experts suggest, one should not try to go long on Nifty unless it has decisively closed above 15,900. And with the new July contract in action, 15,700 remains an important psychological support. With this final update, I'm very confident that you are all now equipped to start planning for your trades next week. So don't forget to register for the StockGrow Leagues. And at StockGrow, we also have some very exciting news coming up about the crypto markets. So watch out. Until then, don't forget to tell us in the comments section whether next week is a buy on dips or a sell on rises. We at StockGrow shall continue making investments social. Until next time, adios amigos.